Okay, today is Top 5 Wednesday, and Jermaine, since we're going on vacation next week, our listeners are going to have a tough time trying to make it without our signature insight on news, weather, and sports. And you know, our sports listeners especially will have a tough week without us to give them their daily fix of sports on WJSU. And I kind of feel bad for the family members of our listeners because they'll be seeing mom and dad or brother and sister acting weird and strange all next week at 5:15, and they'll be thinking to themselves, what is it about WJSU sports that has my dad going nuts while they're out? Well, today's top five is the top five reasons your mom and dad loves listening to sports on WJSU.
Number five.
And number five is, reason number five is they love our groundbreaking interviews where we ask the questions and get the answers that you want to know. Listen to this clip from our interview with JSU head football coach Rick Comegy. Now, my wife asked me specifically to ask you this question. Why is it that football players pat each other on the butt after every play?
Feels good. Nah. You know, that's just congratulatory. You know, they do it all the time. You know, it's just something part of the game.
Number four.
All right, number four. Reason number four is they love our in-depth reporting and analysis of SWAC sports. Take a listen to this. This makes the next few weeks of SWAC East Division football very interesting. With that loss and Alabama A&M's win over Alabama State Saturday, Alcorn fell to third place in the East Division behind Alabama A&M and Jackson State, who are tied at first in the division. Of course, Mississippi Valley is in last place. They have about as good a chance of winning the division as President George Bush does of winning an NAACP Humanitarian Award for its efforts during Hurricane Katrina.
Number three.
Okay, number three. Reason number three is that not only do they get top-notch sports coverage, but they also get valuable relationship advice. Check out this. Now, many of you may have heard about ESPN baseball analyst Steve Phillips and his recent affair with a 22-year-old ESPN production assistant. Now, I would never in a million years think of ever being unfaithful to my wife. Not even if Beyonce and Alicia Keys were waiting for me when I get home today.
Number two.
Number two. Reason number two is they love the best weekly countdown segment on any sports radio show in the state, Wednesday's Top 5. In honor of the performance of the national anthem by Glenn Jones at the Capital City Classic, we've compiled a list of the top five worst ever national anthems.
And the home of the brave.
Number one.
And the number one reason they love listening to WJSU Sports is because they love our unmatched reporting of breaking news. Remember, we were the very first to take you inside of Tiger Woods' house and tell you what really happened on the night of the car accident. Right now, I'm going to take you inside of the Tiger Woods household in the early morning of Friday, November 27th. And this is what I think happened.
It all started when Tiger's wife, Ellen, saw Tiger sitting in the kitchen.
Tiger, we need to talk.
Ellen, we've been fighting all night. I got scratches and bruises on my face, and what are you doing with my golf club?
I want to ask you this again. Are you messing around with that woman?
Ellen, I told you already that nothing... Hey, what the...
You're lying, Tiger!
Are you crazy?
Yes, stop lying to me before I hit a hole in one.
I can't believe you just did that. I'm out of here.
What happened?
Well, ma'am, at this point, Tiger runs out and gets in his Escalade and begins to pull out. But Ellen chases him with the golf club. And that's when the Friday the 13th music starts playing.
Get back here, Tiger!
Heck, you just busted out my back windows, you maniac!
I'm not done with you! Get back here!
What happened?
Well, that's when Tiger speeds out of the driveway and hits his neighbor's tree, the fire hydrant, and he also hits a dog.
I bust the windows out to come.